Our task in this video is to write the equation of a line in point-slope form, in slope-intercept form, and in standard form for this graph. So we have a line, and we need to write the equation based on that line. So first off, we'll start using the point-slope form. Now, point-slope form, again, as the name suggests, we need a point and we need a slope. First, remind yourself what point-slope form is by writing out what the equation of that general form is. So in order to use the point-slope form, we'll need a point and we'll need the slope. So let's just pick one of these two points that are shown here. It doesn't matter which. If we use this one, let's say, that'll be just fine. So that's the point 1, 2. And next we need the slope of that line. In order to find the slope, we'll need the slope formula, which is a formula that you should write down. If it's not in your notes, it should be. So let's figure out what that formula is. So we have y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Remember, y's are on the top and x's are on the bottom. So we'll use these two points and we'll plug in their equation or their coordinates. So we've got 3 minus 2. And then we'll divide by negative 2 minus 1. So that gives us 1 divided by negative 3. And there's our slope. And all that's left to do is to substitute the slope and the point into point-slope form. So once again, we have y minus y1, which we know is 2. So we'll fill that in. Y minus 2 is equal to the slope, which we found to be negative 1/3, times the quantity x minus x1. x1 was 1, so we'll just plug in a 1. So we have y minus 2 is equal to negative 1/3 x, negative 1/3 times the quantity x minus 1. So now we'll use the point slope form for the slope intercept form. So slope intercept form, once again, let's remind ourselves what that form looks like. And just like in the previous video, we'll use the point slope form to find the slope intercept form. So recall what the point-slope form was from the previous problem. So using algebra, we'll take the point-slope form and we'll turn it into something that looks like mx plus b, and we'll isolate y as well. So to start off, let's use the distributive property on negative 1/3 times the quantity x minus 1. So negative 1/3 times x, of course, is just negative 1/3 x. And then negative 1/3 x times negative 1, we would add plus 1/3. And that still equals y minus 2. And now we'll add 2 to both sides in order to isolate y by itself. So we're left with y equals negative 1/3 x plus 2.5. Or, excuse me, 2 1/3. And so now we have our equation in slope-intercept form. Next, let's take that and convert it into standard form. So we want to take our slope-intercept form and turn it into standard form. Remember, a, b, and c are all integers, and in particular, a is a positive integer. So as it stands right now, we've got y on one side of the equation and x on the other side. Let's fix that and add the opposite, add 1/3 x to both sides of the equation. And now remember, these coefficients have to be integers. Coefficients are the numbers a, b, and c. Here I've got 1/3, here I have 2 1/3, and neither of those are integers. So I'll need to multiply both sides of the equation by the denominator. Here I've got 3, I've also got 3. So if I multiply both sides of the equation by 3, then those fractions will become integers. You will distribute the 3. So 3 times 1/3 is just 1, so we're left with x. 3 times y is 3y. Oh, pardon me. and that equals 2 1/3 times 3. So 2 1/3 times 3, 2 1/3 is the same as 7/3. And 7/3 times 3 is 21/3. And 21 is divisible by 3, which equals 7. So that tells me that this side of the equation, 2 1/3 times 3, is 7. And there we go. Standard form of that line. So a quick recap. In point slope form, the equation of that line was y minus 2 is negative 1/3 times the quantity x minus 1. Slope intercept form is y equals -1/3 x plus 2 1/3. And standard form is x plus 3y is equal to 7.